Welcome to the FPS Microgame Prototype. This video is part of our prototype series, in which we explore creating small projects focused on game mechanics. We wanted to create a prototype that shows how to implement a very dynamic movement mechanic, the wall run. We also spent some time working on the level design to interact with the new mechanic and the overall look. Everything shown here is available to download and experiment with yourself. And we've also created a more in-depth workshop video walking through more details. Both can be found on the Unity Learn site via the link in the description below. In this video, we'll look at the purpose of the player controller, how the wall run works and the logic behind it, and how we added polish to enhance the feature. In the upcoming videos about this prototype, we'll explore how we updated the graphics pipeline to achieve our new look, and how we created a custom level tailored to the wall run feature that we added. Many modern FPS games allow the user to perform a wall run move. This game mechanic brings new possibilities, allowing players to reach new places in the level, explore in a unique way, and much more. We wanted to prototype this feature without recreating an entire game. This is why we chose to start with the FPS Microgame project as our base. This original project, also available via the link in the description below, is an FPS template and comes with all the basic stuff that we needed to start prototyping the wall run. The FPS microgame gave us a great starting point with the player's movement, shooting, and the enemy's logic already implemented. Let's start by looking at the player's movement. The player can move and strafe using the WASD keys and can look around by moving the mouse. Holding the shift key, the player can also sprint while moving, and using the space button, they can jump. The player character controller script keeps track of whether the player is on the ground or not using an isGrounded Boolean variable. While jumping, the player isn't grounded anymore, and isGrounded reflects the state, becoming false. Using this variable, the player character controller can distinguish between jumping, falling, and grounded states. For instance, while the player is jumping, the script applies a vertical custom gravity in order to take the player back to the ground. If they are grounded, the normal movement parameters apply. All the parameters used by the script are customizable through the inspector, so we can change everything to get the type of movement we would like to have. Before creating the full wall running feature, we defined all the conditions needed for the player to be allowed to wall run. The first was to detect if the player was jumping or moving on the ground, and as we mentioned, the player character controller already knows this and tracks it in the isGrounded flag. We needed to be sure that this flag is set to false before checking anything else, meaning that the player is not grounded. Besides this, we wanted to allow wall running only if the player is also moving, or to be more precise, if the player is pressing the movement key. The last condition to satisfy was to define a minimum height and check if the distance from the player to the ground was greater than it. Next, we started detecting walls around the player. At the beginning of the wall run script, in the start method, we declared all the directions that we want to check. For each direction, we used a raycast to check if we hit something. A raycast, as the name suggests, is a ray projected from an origin point in a direction. We used the player's position as the origin point and all the directions previously defined as the directions to check in. If we hit something, we check if the hit object is perpendicular to the ground, and if it is, we start wall running. Using the same logic as the player character controller, we define the isWallRunning flag to distinguish the new state that we have created. During this state, we rotate the player's camera on the z-axis based on the side of the wall. If the wall is on the left of the player, we rotate it to minus 30 degrees, and if it's on the right, we rotate it to plus 30 degrees. To move the player along the wall, we basically kept the forward direction, then we multiply it by our custom speed and apply it to the character velocity of the player character controller component. This is what it's used to move the player forward. In the end, in order to polish our wall running mechanic, we made some small adjustments. We exposed a parameter to add the possibility of using the wall run only while the player is sprinting. Also, we added a timer that controls the time necessary for the player to attach to the wall after a jump. Another important parameter that we exposed is a value that affects the player during the wall run. This is a custom gravity that slowly drags the player down to the ground, preventing them from wall running forever or easily running up walls. The last thing we did to add polish to our mechanic was to create a custom post-processing volume specifically for the wall run. When the player attaches to the wall, the weight of the volume gradually increases to create a fast transition from the normal post-processing effect to the wall run look. This does two things. First, it tells the player that they have succeeded in activating the wall run state. Second, it makes the movement feel faster and more exciting. In the upcoming videos, we will explore how we enhance the look of the existing FPS microgame by changing the graphics pipeline from the built-in renderer to the high-definition render pipeline, and how we created the custom level to allow us to really have fun with the wall running mechanic. The FPS microgame prototype is available to download for free via the link in the description below. We've also recorded a slightly longer workshop video that is published on the Unity Learn website. You can find a link for that in the description as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.